Now I go to another lab. Basically, that lab is from the lab name is Strength of Material, so which is applicable to both. It's an underdeveloped lab, both mechanical and civil engineering. So here the approach of strength of material is different. If you go for PIC lab, you will normally find UTM testing and all those stuff. So those kind of lab is also available. It is also named as strength of lab, and that is available in civil discipline. But here I would like to show you one of the lab, which later on I'm going to talk about this. So this is a strength of material, which you can use as a basically while online teaching purpose. So here I could show a list of experiments. And first example I'm going to show is this bending for moment and force. Okay. So again, I'm not going to show theory, pretest and procedure. I'm directly going to hit the simulation. Okay. So here again, some two questions are there. Question one and question two, something like is there. So those are not the only limited question. These are the question just to try out this lab. Now you can set on your own a different sets of question, and this simulator is capable of solving that question. Okay, it's not only those questions. So even numerical method, you can also set up your own question. Okay, and you can solve it with the help of that. So here some question is there. So I just do not follow this question. So I say my beam length is 1 meter. So let's try out. It solves a different question. Yes, it has shown me 1 meter. The question was different. Okay, it's not necessary. Okay, you can try in this way. You can set up your own question and let the student know, okay, you click on question one and solve my question. No issue. Select the number of forces. So I can hit 2. So immediately it will be available 100. So I put some values here in this case. So I put 0.2. Okay, 0.2 meters. Let's say 200, maybe 0.8. Okay, something like this. I will put the value and then submit button. Okay, so now for this, immediately reactions are available. And now you have to start building a shear force and the bending moment diagram. Okay, so put the shear force. So student will put one. So let us say I put 100. I do the mistake. Okay, so it will say verify, oops, your answer is wrong. So that means here, step by step, what we are missing in online teaching is the step by step assistant to the student, whether at this level I'm correct or not, at this level I'm correct or not. So here each step is made to sure that they follow a correct procedure and correct step, and then they move ahead to final solution. So instantly he will do rechecking and all the thing. Okay, if he still not getting, if he keeps on trying, after 3-4 times, he will show you, okay, you are not able to do it. This is what is the answer. That option is also available here. So verify. So 120 is correct. Okay. And then second stage at second point at this location is also a 120. Okay. Then of course, I have to subtract, let us say 200. So it's supposed to be minus 80. No, so 180. Okay, 100 I have to minus, sorry. So 20. Okay. And of course, once I got the 20, then rest of the thing I can put down the value. This will be also 20. Okay, after 20, it will be minus 180. Okay, and finally, it will be minus 180. Okay, so now all the answers have been correct. It is a step-by-step calculation we have done. It's a different tool. Okay, so it's not virtual lab. It's not about doing or representing the actual physical, representation or conversion. You can easily use this as a your teaching assistant tool for your classroom teaching also. Show the shear force diagram So immediately, since all the points we have calculated, we get all the shear force and diagram. Similarly, now we can start going ahead, calculate the bending moment each and every location, and you keep on doing solving the step-by-step procedure. Now this procedure is very long, so I'm not going to tell you. You can try on your own, follow all this procedure, and immediately you will also get a bending moment diagram. And of course, you can move, hover the mouse on the your that particular graph. You could have the all the values available, and on these values, you could also ask the questions, okay, which could be at the analyze level. Okay, so that's all from my side. Thank you for patience listening. Meenal ma'am, over to you.